Okay, then of course we need to do addition and subtraction in the binary. We are now dealing with the binary system to the base 2. So first thing is addition. If I want to add two numbers which are the binary numbers, then how I will do them? You should always keep in mind that when you are dealing with the decimal 2 to the base 10, this is exactly equal to 10 to the base 2. If your number 2 is in the decimal, we just learned that the corresponding binary number of 2 is 10. So at any stage, if you get, like if you are adding 2, 1, 1, then of course you will get 2. So you will not write this 2. Actually, you will write 10. But we also saw that when 1 was in the decimal and I wanted to convert this 1 into this binary, we saw that the result was same. It is exactly 1 in the decimal, it is also 1 in the binary. So 1 has no change. So I have two numbers, 1101, and the second number is 111. I want to add this. Now, when you add something in the decimal, for example 239 plus 39, what happens? 9 is added to the 9, the result is 18, and 1 goes to the carry. When there was something exceeding the base, it was 18. 18 is actually exceeding the base 10. So I put the 1 to the carry. Similar is the case here. When something will exceed the base, you will take it as the carry to the other place. Now 1 plus 1 is, what is 1 plus 1 in the binary?
10.
Yes. Now 10, you cannot write it simultaneously here. You will write 0 just like the 18. You write 8 and 1 to the carry. So 0 here and 1 is carried over there. Now again 1 plus 1. It is again 10. 0 here, 1 to the carry. Now 1 plus 1 plus 1. It is 11, not 10. When you will add 3 ones together, it becomes 11. So you will write 1 here and 1 to the carry. And this 1 plus 1 is again 10. Similarly, now we are moving to the subtraction. This is the decimal. I am subtracting this thing. And this is the binary. This is the decimal. Now this is 0, this is 0, this is 0. So I have to carry something from here. This is 1. When I will carry 1 place from this, then this will become 10. And then from here I will borrow 1. Then this will become 10, but this will become 9. And from here, when I will borrow 1 to there, it will become 10 and this will become 9. Right? And this becomes 0. So actually you have taken 1 place from this digit 1, and the 1 place was worth of 10. From this worth of 10, you took 1 place to there and it became 9. You know this very well, how to do this subtraction. So you are from there you are confused with 2 and 10. So actually you are borrowing 10 from all the places. So here you must keep in mind that your carry will be, your borrow will be 2, because you are in the base 2. You are dealing with the base 2. So these 3 are 0. So I actually have to borrow something from here, from this 1. When I will borrow from this 1 unit, it will give me a 2 here and this will become 0 because I borrowed this thing to here. Now because of the unit system, it become 2, just like when I borrowed, it was 1. When I borrowed 1 thing from here, it became 10 here because of the unit system. Now, from these two, I again want to borrow something here. So it will become 2, and now these two become 1 because 1 I have taken here. Again, from this place, when I will take 1 to this place, this become 2, this is 1. So now, from these two, I can subtract 1, it becomes 1. Now here I left with 1. 1, this is, so the value of this thing is 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. Here I am left with 1. And this 1 minus 0 is 1. Now here is 0. And I will take 1 carry from there. Now this will become 0. And this will become 2. So 2 minus 1, it is 1. So the only thing you should keep in mind that your borrow is now 2, not 10. 2's complement of 2 binary numbers. Given a positive integer, there is a definition and we will do an example and then you can understand. Given a positive integer a, any number a in the decimal, 2's complement of this a, now this a number is actually in the base 10. And I want to find a binary complement of this decimal digit. Then the 2's complement of a is 2 raised to the power n minus a. This is the 2's complement. Do you know what is complement? If we have a set R and we have a set A up to 10, then the complement of A is actually the difference of R and A. It is actually this difference in sets is just like our subtraction, just like this symbol. It is actually this set minus this set. So it becomes all 1 to 10 will be subtracted. So you are left with 11, 12, 13 up to 100. So actually this set is a complement of this set with respect to this set. So the same thing we are finding here, and we are trying to find the complement of number A with respect to the binary system. And we said that the complement of number A with respect to the binary system will be this formula. Okay? Normally in your computer system, the bit system is 16 and 32. The bit length means the number of combinations of 0 and 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, so on, up to 1. So they are total, in total, they are 16. The combination, the full whole digit. Or they are a combination of total 32 digits. This is the most recent length of a number which is used in the computer language. But here, since we are doing the things manually, so we will stick up to the 8 digits. So we will only focus on the numbers having 8 digits, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So the total number, the total digits are 8. If we have one more digit like this, then we will truncate this number and we will remove the first digit. From the left, we will truncate and we will consider the only 8 digits number. If we have 10 digits, then we will remove the both first two digits and we'll make it 8. So in any case, if you get a binary number whose number of digits are more than 8, then cut down the left digits to make it number 8. So in this case, n will be 8 for any number. For example, if I ask you to find me the binary complement of 27, then how will you find? My formula is 2 raised to the power n minus a. I'm asking you that a is 27. Give me an answer. Then you know the n. We have already fixed the n. N will always be 8. So my answer will be 2 raised to the power 8 minus 27. And I have to convert this whole thing stuff into the binary digit. That will be my answer. So your answer will always be a binary number, because you are giving me a 2's complement of a decimal number, then it should be a binary number. Question is, find 2's complement of 27. So I'm saying that my A is 27. I know by default N will be 8, because whenever you prepare a code in the computer, I don't know, are you guys working on computer coding now, or you didn't start?
We are working on, sir.
Okay, so whenever you start building a code, you always define certain criteria for the code. And you define the bit length. So if you are dealing with the number theory in the computer system and you are building a code for the number theory, then computer do not know what do you want. So you will tell the computer that I want the answer in 8 digits, in 16 digits, in 32 digits. Your answer must always be power of 2. So now you are the person who will tell him that whether you want 2 raised to the power 2, or you want 2 raised to the power 3, or you want 2 raised to the power 100, or 1000. A system, whenever the things will go from here to here, for computer it is much easier to give you answer in this bit length. It becomes a little difficult in this bit length. It becomes a whole complicated to give you answer in this bit length. So that's why the lengthy codes having the longer bit length, they can take overnight to run one iteration in the computer code. So for simplicity here, we have fixed the smaller bit length 8, because we are working with hand. But in computer recently, most programmings, they involve either 16 or 32. If 32, that is best. Otherwise, 16 is most appropriate in the recent machine systems. But the rule will be the same. So it is up to you. Everywhere in every bit length, rule will be the same. Rule of addition, subtraction, complement, everything, the rule will be the same. So whatever we will do with the bit length 8, the same you will do with the bit length 16. But in that case, the number of combinations will increase. Just like when we were having PQ, the number of combinations were 4. 1, 1, 100100. But when we added another variable R, now what happened? The number of combinations reached up to 8. So actually we added 2 raised to the power 3. The number of variables n is 3. So it made us, because everything has 2 possibilities, every variable. So the base is 2 and the number of variables are 3. So it gave me 8 possibility. Similarly, if you add another variable, then the base is 2 because every variable has 2 possibilities, 0, 1. But the number of variables are 4, so it becomes 16. If you add another variable, it becomes 32. 2 raised to the power 5 and so on. I want a complement of 27 according to the bit length 8. Means I want a binary number of 8 digits, 8 bits. So the complement, by definition, I know it is 2 raised to the power, minus a. This is the rule. This is the formula. That is 2 raised to the power 8. What is a? A is 27. The power 8 is 256 minus 27, 29. Now, this is the complement of a in the decimal. I don't need this answer. I need an 8 bits binary number. So I will convert this 229 into the binary number. And you already know how to convert a decimal into a binary number. One. So actually you make table like this. You actually want to make the things in the power of 2. So 128 I write it here, then 64 I write it here, then 32, 1.2 raised to the power 5. Then now after 32 I should have 16 and 8. But in this case, I do not see them. I directly jump to 4. So I will add a 0 with 16, 2 raised to the power 4, plus 0 with 8, 2 raised to the power 3, plus I have 2 raised to the power 2, 1.2 raised to the power 2, plus 4, I should have a 2, but I don't have any 2. So it will be a 0. 2 raised to the power 1 plus the leftover 1 into 2 raised to the power 0. This is the corresponding binary digit for 229. What is it? 1. Now just collect these and write them all together. 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1. How many digits? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, I wanted a digit, a binary digits having 8, a binary number having 8 digits, and I got it. This is a 2's complement of 27. In decimal, for the limit 256, the complement of 27, if I say 256 is the bigger set R and the smaller set A is 27, then the complement of A is R minus A. That is 256 minus 27, it is 229. So the complement of the number A in the decimal is 229. But I needed a 2's complement of 27, means I had originally a number in the decimal system and I needed a 2's complement of decimal number. So I first converted into a decimal complement here, and then I converted this decimal number into a binary number, which is an 8-digit number, and this is 2's complement of 27.
Sir, 0101111.
Now we have a tape. The tape is, whatever A is, write it, the binary number of A, binary number, convert it into the binary, and then flip all the zeros with 1 and 1 with 0. I'll do it and you will understand. And then add 1. I need 8 bits binary number for 36. I know 36 equals to, if I write them in the binary, they become 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. I need to complete the 8. So I can simply, for example, if you have 11, this is equal to 011. Or 13, this is equal to 013. So you can add 0 on the left. So I can add 2 zeros on the left. Now it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is an 8-digit binary number, which is a binary number for the number 36. So I derived a shortcut that first find the 8-digit. You must make sure that you find an 8-digit number. If the digits are less, then on the left put zeros to make it 8. I am done with this step. Now flip the zeros with 1 and 1s with zeros. Wherever there is a 0, make it 1. This 1 becomes 0. 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Now, in this number, add 1. 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. I want to add 1 into this number, so I actually have 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So if you add them together, what is the result? 1, 1.
0.
1 goes there. 1, 1. 0. 0. 1 goes there.
0.
1, 0, 1. 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So this is the complement, binary complement of 36. So whose answer was this?
Mine, my sir.
Okay, so Rayane was wrong and Ibtisam was right. There is a small definition. The complement of a complement gives you back the original number. If you have a complement of A, if you take another complement of A, it will become A, the original set. Similarly, a complement of a number, if I am asking for a complement for a number A, now this is my number. This is actually the complement. And if I want ask you, whatever the answer is, I ask you to find the complement of this answer of this thing. Then how will you find? The formula will be same. I say, let me say the answer of this whole thing is B. Then the formula, and I am asking you to find the complement of B, the formula will be 2 raised to the power 8 minus B. So it is actually 2 raised to the power 8 minus, what is B? B is 2 raised to the power 8 minus A. These cancel, this A becomes. So actually, the complement of a complement is actually the original number A. So this, I am getting back the original number A. And the next thing is, if I have a number which I am saying is a complement of any decimal number, let me say 10101001. I am claiming that this number is actually the complement of A. A was a decimal number. I worked on it and I found its complement, and that complement is this. So my question is, this is a complement. Give me the value of A. Go back. So again, just like into the circuits, he is asking us to go back to the initial stage. So what to do? Reverse those steps. If you have a complement and you want to find the decimal, this is the number. The next step is flip the bits. Means 0 becomes 1 and 1 becomes 0. Now next stage is add 1 into that number. And then whatever the answer is, just write it into the decimal form. So that will be the value of A. Okay, so let us do this one here. This is the complement. First step is flip the bits. So wherever there is 1, I'll make it 0. And 0 will become 1. Right? Now this is step 2. Add 1 into it, so it means 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. It becomes 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. Right? Am I right? Now, simply write this thing into the decimal, the next step. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 0.2 raised to the power 7. Just like that. 1. Now this 1.2 raised to the power 6 plus 1.2 raised to the power 1 plus 1.2 raised to the power 0. Now simplify the powers of 2 and add them together. Is it 64, 16, 80, 84, 86, 87?
87.
So, yeah. So this number is actually a 2's complement of 87. Now you can cross check that are we right or not. So we can go back from 87 to, you can go back from 87 to this number.